Hey, what's going on, guys? Right on the music here, bringing you another video. Today, I wanted to make a video just talking about what's coming to Forza 7, or like what you should expect, or like some new things that you might not like have heard about at E3 that are actually in the game or coming to the game. So basically, for the past week and a half, I've just been listening to interviews with the people that work at Turn 10, or like just people playing the game on YouTube, or like articles that have been from like press that have reviewed the game or tested the game or whatever. So I've made a huge ass list of all the things, and I will go over that today. I'll start with the obvious things, of course. The game will be 4K at 60 frames for Xbox One X users and high-end PC users, I assume. Regular Xbox One users won't be able to play it in 4K, obviously, but I assume if you have a... I feel like they didn't talk about this, but I feel like if you have an Xbox One S with HDR compatible TV, I feel like it will get like a slight upgrade like Forza Horizon 3 did. So maybe you'll have that, but anybody on like the regular Xbox One, they'll just get like the regular upgrades that come with buying the newer game rather than like the far advanced stuff like 4K and all that. It's the first Forza Motorsport to have Xbox Play Anywhere compatibility, so if you own it on the console, you can own it on the PC at the same time. And you can switch back and forth, and your game save is in the cloud, so it's continuous from back and forth. I hope that means there's network compatibility for online, because that will hopefully prolong the life of the game. So far for me, like, a Forza usually lives about 6-7 months or so. I really stopped playing Forza Horizon 3, like, maybe in April or something like that. But what I always usually do is go from... Like, so let's say a Horizon comes out, I'll go back to the Motorsport that came out before that Horizon. So with Horizon 2, I went back to Forza 5. And then with Horizon 3, I went back to Forza 6. So that kind of keeps you in the game, but not in the game. But hopefully, with this cross-compatibility, if it's there, you will not experience that. And the game will stay, like, alive for a while, you know what I mean? This is an important one here. Forza 6 had about 350 cars at launch, if I remember correctly. This one has double that at 700. Yeah, you have almost 1,000 cars available at launch in the game that don't include, like, DLC or anything like that. But this does include Porsches and NASCAR from the launch. So they're full-on in the game. No expansions, nothing like that. There will be 30 environments, and that's a quote from Turn 10's website. I assume that means track locations, not just, like, different track layouts. It's gonna be 30 straight-up, like, places that you go, like, let's say the difference from Lime Rock to, like, Spa to Nürburgring. It's gonna be 30 different, like, actual places. They're bringing some new locations, and some fan-favorite locations are returning. So far, they've confirmed Maple Valley is in the game, which is awesome. I've always liked that track a lot from the older Motorsports. There's a new trek called the Feet Mountain Pass. It's the Dubai trek from the gameplay that you've probably watched a bunch of times from E3. Track that I like that's in other games currently that's coming back, Magello, that's coming back. There's no word on Fujimi Kaido, at least I haven't seen anything about it or like heard if it's confirmed or not. I wouldn't get your hopes up, just because if they announce Maple Valley so openly, I don't see why they wouldn't announce Fujimi Kaido if it was coming. So, yeah, don't get your hopes up for it, but hopefully it'll be there. Or it might be, like, a secret for a later date or something. Like I said, NASCAR's in the game straight up from the beginning, so that's cool. There's a new UI for the menus and lobbies, as well as in, like, the race HUD. And, if you've watched any people's gameplays of it, I have, and I personally really like the new in-game HUD. Like, it's, in Forza 6 and stuff, it's a little distracting, because it's, like, in your face. And you're kind of, like, looking at it more than, like, your race sometimes. At least for me. But the new one, it's kind of, like, skewed at, like, an angle. So it draws your eyes into the center of the screen. So you're, like, focused on the race. But the way it's, like, set up, you see it in the corner of your eye. And you can still read it. Without having to, like, fully look at it. Which is awesome. Now, another big part of the game that's being fixed. Or not fixed, but more, worked on is the new weather system. Forza 6 was the first motorsport to introduce rain, and it was alright. It was kind of weird. I personally wasn't a fan. I don't really like the rain in that game. But this game has a more refined weather system. Puddles on the track will change and grow like larger over time as the race goes on if it's continuing to rain. Or I think they might dry up as well. They're bringing over their dynamic, like, realistic skies from Forza Horizon 3. So you'll see the storm in the distance, and as it gets closer, it will start to drizzle, and then it will turn into full-on rain with, like, thunder and lightning. It's gonna be pretty awesome. And, another thing that has to kind of do with the weather, it's more of track stuff, but, the road temperature will change, and it will have an impact on, like, your car's handling and grip and friction. And, that's pretty cool, too. So I guess, like, nighttime you'll have a little less grip, or if it's, like, raining at night, which I don't even know if it's possible. It's not possible in 6, so I don't know about 7. But, yeah, that sounds like a terrible time. some new gameplay stuff that we have. First of all, there's a new single player. It's called Driver's Cup. And it consists of 6 major championships where you rack up points per race to unlock new cars and driver gear, which I'll get to later on in this video. Showcases will come back, so it will be like, I don't know if it's going to be like full-on you race like a jet or something, but it might be like the old stuff that they used to have where you had to do like a autocross or whatever it's called, where you drive through cones and do all that stuff. So that might be a thing, if that's what they mean by that. There's a new reward system where the more cars you own in the game, the greater your after-race rewards will be. So you'll get more money for owning more cars. And leagues will be back and supposedly will be upgraded, which is cool. I actually enjoyed doing some of the league stuff. Especially because you got like unlock rare cars with it that nobody gets. They were a little more competitive, and people were less, like, they weren't trying to hit you off the road, because they were also trying to get points to get these cars. They took it seriously. There's new pre- and post-race screens that involve your driver. So, like, you'll stand on a podium after the race, and, like, you'll see your driver in the main lobby and stuff like that. They also added a new friction assist that's under, it's, like, with traction control and all that. And what it does is it affects how your car reacts to driving off the road. Like into grass or sand or something like that. So, if you feel like it sucks you in too much, it will, like, help you with that a little bit. I just hope it's not, like, too helpful where it's, like, you just leave it on so you don't get screwed over for cutting the track. But, I'm sure they'll handle that. Now, one of the, bigger changes to the game is that you now have a customizable driver. You saw it a little bit in, Horizon 3, where you could, like, pick a different character to play as, kind of. Like, you could pick from, like, a different person. This one's a little different, where it's, like, you still look like the Stig, or, like, a race driver, where you're in the fire suit, and you, or the racing suit, I guess. And you get a helmet and gloves and all that. This one, they allow you to customize your racing suit, your helmet, your gloves, your hands device, which is, like, that neck brace type of thing that drivers have. You could pick between male and female drivers. You also get different body types, so I guess you could be tall, short, fat, or skinny. And hopefully that affects your seating position and not just what your dude looks like. Because that would be cool. If you're like taller and your guy looked taller in the car and had a different view, yeah, it would kind of give you an advantage in some cases, but that would be cool anyway. Overall, they supposedly have 300 different designs for your racing gear that you could pick from, which also includes, like, pop culture stuff or, like, vintage stuff. One other thing that has to do with this I'll talk about later because it fits more into, like, the next section, which would be more refined details. Now, to me, when they first announced Forza 7 at E3, I was, like, a little disappointed because it's not a huge change like Project Cars is getting or, like, anything else is getting. But, I really thought about, like, what this game actually is, and it's just, it's weird. It's almost like a Forza 6 upgrade. But, once I realized what they're actually changing, it's reasonable, and I get it. I understand the game now, and I'm actually hyped for it. And I'll get into all that with this section, with the more refined details. First of all, your driver will have scratches and scuffs on your helmet for like wear and tear and stuff like that, which just adds to like a little bit of detail that you would see to immerse you more into the game. You'll also like, so you could pick from NASCAR like drivers or like professional drivers gear. So like you could wear like a Jeff Gordon helmet or something like that or whatever. But you'll also have their signature on your helmet, like their real actual signature, which is pretty cool. The game obviously has 4K, so everything's going to just be a little bit more detailed and a little bit clearer. So that's going to be a noticeable detail. Some objects on the cars now shake in the wind under like high speed, like your windshield wipers will wiggle around, or your if your car is like a window net like NASCAR or something like that, that will shake in the wind. And that also includes better audio. So they've taken the time to upgrade the audio in the game. And I was reading about it, and it actually sounds pretty cool. Especially being like somebody that does music stuff and all that. And I like what they were thinking. So basically, depending on the type of car you're in, like if you're in like a race car, like a GT3 race car or something that has like no insulation or interior, and it's literally just a metal box with like a roll cage, you'll hear a difference between that or something like a Bentley or like a Rolls Royce or even just like a regular like sedan. Like you're gonna hear like the echo of the engine in the road and like gravel and stuff off the interior of the car that just gets like amplified just because you're in a tin can, which is pretty awesome. That's something in Project Cars that I think I actually really enjoyed, that I noticed when I played that game. And the fact that Forza is now getting that is pretty cool. Another thing they also worked on is music. So if you've played all the motorsports, you know that you always get that weird, like, elevator type of music. Or it's like, now they're more towards, like, classical music, I guess. Or it's like, cinematic stuff. They've decided to go with more realistic music that people would listen to and, like, hear on, like, a radio in a garage or something like that. Which is awesome, because I'm not watching a movie and playing Forza. Another thing with the music is that they've mentioned that there's customizable music. I don't know if that means you could pick like a set of songs that are in the game and make like a playlist out of it, or if that means they'll bring over the groove music thing that they had in Horizon, where you could just connect that and listen to your own stuff. But location and stuff like that actually changes what the music sounds like. So like if you're in a lobby, it just sounds regular. But if you switch over to your garage to tune your car, it sounds like it's in a garage, like across the room. Or if you go in Forza Vista and climb in the car, it sounds like it's muffled, like you close the car doors and you can't hear it that much anymore. Or, like, let's say you're racing. You'll hear it when you pass, like, the grandstand area. And then as you get further away, it gets quieter, which is pretty cool, too. Now, for the last thing that I've really read about that seems to be getting a change, I haven't heard much about it. I've like heard it now and then that they keep mentioning it, is that the wheel settings and physics are going to get upgraded for like if you have a racing wheel, like a Thrustmaster or a Logitech or whatever. This probably doesn't affect as many people as the rest of the stuff, but I used the wheel myself, so I read up on it as much as I could. And like I said, there's not that many details at the moment, but they've confirmed there will be new upgraded physics for those of us with racing wheels, and they will also have more support for every wheel on the market. They said every fan requested wheel, so I guess that would mean every wheel that at least connects to a modern setup. But yeah, that's basically all the new stuff. But Turn 10 is going to appear at this year's Gamescom in late August, so I'm sure we'll hear more specifics at that event. And I assume the demo will also be announced around then too. And I feel like we'll actually get that on the console in like early to mid-September. And just to recap on this, Forza 7 is set to release on October 3rd for everybody, and September 29th for those willing to dish out the $100 to buy the Ultimate Edition, which I most likely will, because I always do. But yeah, That's basically everything. At least everything that they've announced so far. And I will do another follow-up to this at Gamescom if they announce anything that's worth talking about. That's it for this one, guys. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button below. Let me know what you think about this new Forza, because I haven't talked about it at all on the channel. And I want to know what people think. I want to know if you're excited or if you're kind of bummed that it's not changing too much. Anyways, that's it for this one, guys. See y'all next time.